tutorial explains how to do qualitative analysis in GCMS solution. Before we start, we set the automatic mode of GCMS solution, which can be defined in GCMS solution registry directory. There are two files which I would like to focus on. This is the AutoSpec table LibSearch on registry. We double-click that first to activate an automatic library search in the qualitative table. And we make sure that when we start, the compound name to peak table is switched off as a registry. So double-clicking on registry files activate them. So this software has been set already in the correct way. We use a data file called scanpest, which I loaded here. So in GCMS solution qualitative analysis, we can do manually identification of each peak. We can double click in any peak and we got a spectrum underneath. We could make library search based only on this spectrum, but it's much more precise to have an average of spectra. Therefore, we have three icons here. The left one makes it possible to do an average of spectra over the peak. For this, I go to the left side of that peak, click the mouse, and drag, keep the mouse clicked, and drag the cursor to the end of the peak. I release the mouse, and I have an average spectrum between the retention time indicated here. Of course, it's for small peaks, it's better to subtract background spectra, and there are two ways, and I use the averaging. This is an average of subtraction, and I can use clicking and dragging the cursor over a baseline, but the software is possible to drag it over the peak, and then it takes all the background spectra and subtract it from the peak middle. I release that, and the spectrum at the bottom is similar to the one we had because the peak is so intense, but this is now a background subtracted peak. So we can easily make similarity search either by going with the cursor in the spectrum and put rise mouse bottom and select similarity search, or we select similarity search in the toolbar on the left side. This gives me already the spectrum, the result of the library, in this case done the search on NIST 08, and this is the measured spectrum, this is the first library spectrum, and this is the difference. So to define the library where we would like to search in is under qualitative parameters, similarity search. Here we can select up to five libraries where we can define where to search, and we can also set a minimum similarity in order to discriminate all hits which are below 70% in this case. So this is the manual identification. Also, we can register this to the qualitative table individually by a right mouse button and register to spectrum process table. But I would like to teach here how to do it automatically in the full chromatogram. This is done in qualitative integration, so in the toolbar I select qualitative. And the icon peak integration for all TICs here gives me an integration window which identifies the peak integration parameters. In details, we have a slope we can define, which is the slope of the peaks if the third number of the third point data point the slope is calculated there, and if this slope is bigger than the value given here, the peak is indicated to be recognized to be a peak, not noise. The width usually we use is the smallest width in the chromatogram in equivalent to the first peak. Drift is usually used when we have a drift in baseline. T double should not be zero. It should have a high value because after the T double, time double, in minutes, the software automatically halves the slope and doubles the width, because in long chromatograms you may not be able to use only one slope and on one width. But with standard GCMS chromatograms, we don't need this function, so 1000 means it will never establish in this chromatogram. Minimum area is self-explanatory. We don't want to have any smoothing. There is a possibility to do some time programming and integration, which we don't need at the moment. In the spectrum process, we define the peaks we have to be integrated, whether we take peak top spectrum or average from peak start to peak end, which is defined after integration. Peak top spectrum is clear. If I set average point 3, it takes a peak top spectrum and the two adjacent spectra, and it makes an average over those. Usually I use average from start to end. Of course, the background has to be subtracted like we did. Calculated from peak means it takes the spectrum before and after the peaks if number of average point is 1. If we set this to 2, the first 2 and the first second spectra after the peaks are calculated and subtracted from the peak. So if we press OK, with the registry file we activated, the software tells me that the detected peaks are registered to the spectrum process table, and the system performs similarity search automatically. We press OK, and we see an integration of most of the peaks here, and this integration result must be in the qualitative table. The qualitative table contains two parts. Obviously, the TIC integration, say for example the first peak here, is a start time of 6.217 minutes. The integrated chromatogram was a TIC chromatogram. We have area, area percent, height, and height percent. This is area defined, area over height, and mark indicates whether it is a valley to valley integration like in peak number 6. So first line is peak at starting at 6.217 minutes, and there should be spectral information of that peak, background subtracted. This is in the spectrum process table. Peak number 1 is the spectra information of the integrated peak. So these are scan numbers. Scan numbers can be converted into retention times by view menu. If you click retention time, this is exactly the spectral information of the first peak. Library search has been done automatically. There is no name given at the moment. The software can be set to automatically take the first hit, but usually the first hit is not the right one, so double clicking in that line, we receive the library search result, and the user can confirm and press copy marked name to compounds to spectrum process table if that is the right identified compound. This name is also copied into the TIC table. When in under edit mode, copy compound name to tick peak table is checked. So this can be done for the other compounds too. With a good clean spectrum, and especially when we use linear retention index, the first hit function can be used. So we leave it for these 8 peaks here, and we have all the names in the qualitative integration, and the names appear in the chromatogram. This can be defined under display properties, where we can select compound name in spectrum process table, and correspondingly this name is the TIC table. But if the confirmation is done correctly, these two names are the same. So we see the names and the identification of the compounds here.